I feel really good about it. You never know how you're going to feel, you know? You always want to feel good about it, but... You know, you see how these things get made. Fucking who can tell what the hell's going to happen at the end of the day.
God damn it. Fucking props. Fucking me again. Go wider. Good? Yeah, this will be good. Got
it. Everything pretty much worked as good as I could imagine it working under the crazy circumstances that we shot it all.
I had my doubts, but this has turned out to be quite the enjoyable passion play.
At 31, I knew I needed something that was a factory or some kind of confined space. And it was amazing how hard it was to find something like that.
If you're just going to see the ceiling, I can save us some time and money trying to reduce the amount of lighting.
It's a Spanish
That's all I want to see.
What are you guys
thinking?
Nothing.
Okay. Maybe the long hallway redressed a little bit or something. Maybe it doesn't look... Because none of this...
And we had to cheat two places. We went to this place, Willow Street Studios, which is like this typical place where they shoot, you know, everything.
This is good for general chaos.
Yeah.
We should put scene 20 in here.
We have that
as a backup.
But we should find something better. That's too long of a scene to be stuck in that little fucking... But it was very confining. It seemed claustrophobic. There was a few good rooms. Like, oh, now we need to find something that matches this. It has some scope. And that's how we ended out at the power plant.
Throw a light way deep in that, shooting at beams, rotating or something, yeah. You know?
And then I saw those, I go, oh, we could cheat these for each other. And one here was we could shoot more intimate stuff, and here's where we could shoot bigger things of people running or going up and down stairs, so the movie would feel like it had some scope. But even with that, you know, I mean, the whole movie started out taking place indoors, and when I got to that location, I go, wow, there's this cool bridge going across this dried up, you know, riverbed. Okay. We're gonna end the movie outdoors. Wardrobe is really important to me, and that's always a department that I torture.
Sickhead is pretty much what I've got in the picture and what is described in the script.
Right. It's funny, the further we go along, the more like the clown aspect of it gets on my nerves.
Yeah.
I don't give a shit.
I mean, we went through most of these. They're not... What's the biggest gag? I mean,
probably the beheading. That would kind of dictate how you want to shoot it. You know, if it's already open like that, if you just cover it with the arms, they're cutting, and then you have the blood coming out.
Would it cut open, or it's already
open? And the other way to do it is with a blank throat appliance. It's kind of pre-slit, you know, and as they pull their neck back, opens it up. Well, we can just see how it goes, and you know, if we have time to do it, we can. If we don't, we can shoot it the way we're talking about it.
So these are the jeans that Sheri's character Charlie is wearing, and these are actually a modern pair of jeans. Luckily, we were able to find jeans that had flare leg that made them look 70s, and then we went in and I had the seamstresses add a flare to give them more of a bell bottom. Roscoe's jacket, where again, this was a vintage jacket that we started out brand new, clean, and just did this process where we added some stuff. So this is the pants that Sickhead wore. These actually started as white pants that we took them and we laid down tape and actually painted red stripes on them. So there's really an art to it. It's not just going out and shopping clothes and expecting them to look perfect for camera. You have to create art with them. You have to create the reality, the realism that they've been wearing them for a long time.
I think the handles to hold on shouldn't be any thicker than a baseball bat.
And then these would be the spikes in the division.
Obviously with a movie like this, the props became super important because I wanted each weapon to be, you know, identifiable with each character and be simple, but be something memorable, because at first it was like, well, what if it's all knives? What if it's all this? And I'm like, ah, we'll never remember any of that shit. We'll give each person their own.
Rip out that too.
Like this whole thing?
Well, yeah, like, leave these walls, put a door, rip out all this, and rip out this. What is this?
It was great. We found this cool RV. I knew it wasn't right, so I knew we could rip it apart and paint it and make it, you know, correct.
From a lighting perspective, I really like this.
It's got a lot of windows. If you're going to start in the daytime, that makes a big difference. We established all the geography easy enough.
Yeah.
I know we're crazed and every department feels like they're fucked at this point, probably. But we'll figure it out and we'll do it while we're running and we'll just, you know, that's how we roll.
We go through everything. Hair, wardrobe, stunts, makeup effects, physical effects. You know, how, do you want rain on this scene? Do you want smoke on this scene? Are we going to squib this scene? Are we going to do this? We need blood gag. Preempt problems is really what the production meeting is.
The shape of the schedule, it's a 20-day schedule. We kick off on March 9th.
Basically start stabbing him until Charlie smashes him off.
Yes. Art department are going to hide the concrete, they're going to hide the highway, they might add some wood to the fence.
Let's just get creative and make it happen. Don't worry about being exactly what's in the script. I don't care. The script will bear no relation to the finished film anyway.
All just totally shitty, and again,
I hope everybody has a really good time making this movie, because I think a lot of people have worked with Rob before. And those who haven't will realize pretty quickly, if you haven't already, that you're working on a movie that is going to be talked about. People are going to have opinions about it. It's something that I can say is special, and the people who haven't had that experience yet, I think, will realize it soon.
When I went over to Wayne's shop, we just sit there, we start from scratch, and we have a basic idea, but we just keep evolving it, you know, because at first, you know, you do it, it's not right, you do it, it's not right, you do it, you keep working on it until you feel that it's right. And, you know, me and Wayne have worked together so many times, so usually we may take some side streets and go off on tangents, but we usually arrive at the right place eventually.
So there's variations in it, so it almost looks like, you know, bad skin disease, you know.
Yeah.
You don't have to be perfect, but, you know, that's kind of cool.
And then about that
spacing. Yeah, that space. Yeah, I mean, I guess you can make them sort of uniform, but not perfect.
I just wonder,
you know, we always have stuff around because, you know, Rob just likes to grab and try different stuff, and it was good because we made these just to have this, like, a leathery old skinned face.
You know, I wonder if there's a point in it. You know, this was not...
It's really just texture up on his forehead.
You know, it was kind of called for in the script a couple of places, but he wasn't sure if he was going to use it. So we had him, and now we've adapted him to use him on these guys.
We can glue that back a little bit so it's not so sticky.
Yeah, we should glue that. Give him the comb over. That's kind of rad.
Okay. And now we have the other guy to base it off of somewhat, because they appear together in the movie, and they're kind of cohort, so... They're going to look somewhat similar, but I'm just going to do a few things different so they're not like twins.
I mean, I think it distinguishes him. There's something cool about, like, the most simplistic, least flashy of them all. Is it the most deadly
guy? Yeah.
I guess a little upper torso.
Paint silver on it for now so we can see if it looks good. And if
yeah, let's like try it. Just yeah, it since that's a process, why don't we do a test?
All right. So what's fun about doing stuff with Rob, it's good that he's here and involved, and, you know, we can do it as we go. So if it was the type of guy like, oh, I don't know, I'll know when I see it. And, you know, you come up, spend all this time coming up with something that's nothing like what they like, and then you have to do it again and again and again until you find what they're looking for. He's so creative, and he knows what he wants to see, so this is the best way to go.
You! I'm coming for you! Die! Die! Die!
I'll have a list of actors that I have in mind. Like, sometimes I've written the roles for them, sometimes I haven't. And then... some I just don't know.
It's interesting, though, how the cast was, like, 3 days ago, the cast was sort of like, fuck. We just have to get someone, and then 3 days later, it's kind of like the whole cast is in place, and I think it's like going to be pretty compelling.
Well, no, it always is. That's the thing that's always hard to explain at first. It's never compelling because of one name. It's always becomes compelling because of the ensemble. You suddenly like can rattle off seven or eight names and people go, oh, and it feels like something, but no one name makes you go, oh, yeah. Fuck.
You know, with 31, I always knew it was going to be Sheri. I always knew it was going to be Jeff. I always wanted it to be Meg, but then it was kind of conflicting with the TV show I was on, but we worked it out, so it was Meg. And after that, it became more vague.
Yeah, it's true as the sky is blue.
Well, no disrespect, Father, but the combatants are very... Oh, how should I say this? A tad...
There's always this fallacy like, there's a million actors. It's impossible to stand out. I'm like, no, there's a million actors, but there's not a million good actors. Good people stand out. It's not as much of a crapshoot as people make it sound. The camera test was really helpful because me and Dave had some strong thoughts on lighting things. Very smoky, heavily backlit. And we were able to test out that theory and see if it looked good.
Bring that in the Wussy Bar.
The Wussy Bar.
Who are you going to see first?
Well, Pancho's ready, so we might as well roll him.
Ah, dude. Yo te quiero matar a ti.
So you want me to do like a three and then just to pop in and find him and rack focuses and things
yeah.
like that?
It'll be like this. And you're gonna throw sparks out that way.
Yeah.
Oh, I smell something good. What is
it? Not that there would have been really time to change things around necessarily. But it's nice to see your actors standing together on film. And again, that's something that I haven't had the luxury of doing every time. So, you know, anytime you can do any little thing like that, it's a huge time and money saver. You know, so that worked out well.
What's the next one?
Yeah. It's already starting. I can see that. All right.
Uh-oh.
Every day one's different. This day one's tricky because we only had that location for 2 days. Just like I only had Malcolm for 2 days. You want to get the scope of the place and get it done, but you can't fuck around.
Clear everybody out, shut everybody up, let's do it. Action!
I did open castings and great people came in and read, but I go like, I need somebody that's iconic to play this role or it's just not going to be strong enough. And that's how I end up with Malcolm.
I'm very happy you're back.
Here.
I'm so happy you're back.
Then when Sickhead jumps on Levon, I would just kind of like, back up maybe. And
yeah, because you know, all of a sudden this guy appears. Yeah. And I reckon, Kevin, if you almost... You're like, whoa.
Yeah, we were trying to rehearse the stunts simultaneously. Even though a lot of the stunt work they rehearsed, I just threw away because it was just too complicated. I mean, it may have been phenomenal, but I just knew it was too complicated. It was too stunty, and it would have just taken too long.
I'm scared of just rehearsing. It's going to look so fast and insane, and brutal, you know?
It looks good, man. Thanks so much. Have a good night.
Yeah, I'm excited about my character. He's kind of, guess he's hanging out with these rich people and beautiful women, and we're playing with people's lives, I heard. So that's cool, I'm excited.
Maybe cut off that, like, go wider and cut off that statue. So, what is that?
That's the table. That's what I was trying to avoid, but yeah, we can move the
table. Yeah, we'll cross that bridge of protocol soon enough.
Yeah,
so I just want to change.
The cue cards were his idea. You know, I was fine with it because I knew it was too much. There was just no way he, you know, was like memorizing these long, long speeches. He would have needed it like 2 months, not 2 days. But it worked out fine because I told him it's not an emotional thing. You know, you're sort of giving a speech. So if it sounds sort of rehearsed, like you're reading it, that's okay, because you are sort of giving this performance for your captive. If it was a scene where he was supposed to be really emotionally engaged with somebody, then I wouldn't have asked him.
He's sitting there looking depressed.
Oh, yeah, that's
and
good.
They're dancing around behind him.
Yeah, that's hot.
You know?
That's good.
Because that looks like...
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Just on a sandbag.
Take it up.
Yeah.
Do you want movement, or do you want to put the lambda head on and do some track, or do you want to just be on the...
I think that would be weird moving.
Yeah.
It's a bit crazy.
Just rest
I just want to get this.
Yeah, let's do it.
Sistine Chapel. Cool. And then they'll be behind him. Maybe they're kind of each... What we'll do is... get each of them tracking back and forth, and each time one of them has a line, they'll lean in.
Okay, cool.
And then peel off.
Okay, what's the question?
So, I'm really bummed out.
Yeah,
yeah.
You are not having a good time.
No, you don't have to. Just let your face without a frame, and then you obviously stop.
We have a winner.
How bizarre and extraordinary. How exactly? Shall we, and of course, by we, I mean you, Happiness.
You know what, I think that this is not going to work.
I basically was just like, this ceiling is so amazing, we can't waste it. And no matter how wide we made the lens and how low we put the camera, the ceiling always looked tiny. I'm like, there's no way to grasp the size of the ceiling. But we tried.
Whenever we spend this long setting something up,
either it works in the first...
It usually means it doesn't work.
Right.
And we're trying to force something to happen.
Exactly.
It's not happening.
It was all about scope. I just wanted there to be scope. I don't ever want to fall prey to the fact that it's a low-budget movie, so it should look that way. I'm always trying to, you know, if you can insert some scope into something, it really makes a big difference.
Yeah, this will be good.
Maybe that's what you
do. Nice.
Okay, we're set.
We good? Action!
7 hours and 3 minutes.
I believe it's time to... recalculate the odds. Prepare to open your purses.
Judy, I've known since we were at school together, the year dot, and Malcolm, I've known, first met in the 70s, I guess. And so it's like working with your friends couldn't be nicer. And having the most fantastic costume and makeup where you don't have to do any acting because the costume and the makeup does it all for you.
I can say that to Rob. I'm not going to speak. The makeup, hair, it's doing it all for me.
Yeah.
They think that they get tired of being treated like they don't matter, or getting treated like, oh, you're not 25 anymore, you're useless, stand in the background, you know, your best days are over. That's why, you know, I mean, young actors are fine if that's what you need, but, you know, with things like this, you can be older and still be awesome. You know what I mean? It's like, these actors are great. They've done so much. I mean, that was the thing back in the day. I mean, so many actors would make so many movies before you even heard of them. Like, they really honed something.
In exactly 120 seconds, we will begin. And all you have to do is survive 12 hours inside the walls of our own private little hell.
That was a good day. I mean, it was kind of a weird, it was maybe a good scene to start with because, you know, the captives hadn't, you know, they didn't give them really anything to do together with each other, which is probably good because they were still kind of figuring out who everybody was. It's all handheld out in the sun, yeah. RV, then the sun is going to
Got it. I see what you're saying. That's beautiful. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay, here we go.
If you're going to be a part of a horror film, might as well be a Rob Zombie movie. I mean, they're the most scary, the most violent, the most disturbing. So I was really proud, you know? And then when I got to set, and we did a little bit of testing and camera testing and stuff, and Rob's like, hey, I noticed that you could speak Spanish. But I want you to say your lines in Spanish. He loved it. He said it just brought even more life to the character, so I was game for that. I mean, being an actor, I'm all about like just challenging myself, and that felt like it was going to be a challenge that I was willing to take on.
Feast your eyes and behold, Chickhead!
Happy Halloween, motherfuckers!
It was absolutely fabulous. Really. Excellent.
Have to know. I mean, we did that probably every day with something because you can't let some mistake bring your movie down. You have to find a way, and you can't go off in your trailer and brood about it for hours. You have to just stand there and within 5 minutes go, I got it. This is what we're gonna do.
We're a microcosm of a very particular story where reality and a cacophony of terror envelops us in a world that only Mr. Zombie could create with such eloquence.
You have to be very exact because he's such a perfectionist with what he wants in certain spots and a certain vibe and a certain feeling. So, you know, luckily I had great luck with it and we just created some amazing, really cool, moody, spooky music.
He has touched people in some way, you know what I mean, which is kind of amazing, actually. When, I mean, be it his music, be it his films, to be able to sort of like touch a large portion of people. There's a lot to be said for that, you know what I mean, as far as art is concerned. I thank God that I've been invited along, you know what I mean, for the ride, because it's been a great one.
Action!
Whoa, 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 stop eating!
Why, what wrong?
Just stop!
All we're doing here is we're going to replace your wardrobe with your wig, and if you change back to your persona, you'll be in the mirror. Well, maybe just start with the jacket off, put it on, straighten it, do that.
I like shooting in real locations. Sometimes it's disgusting because it actually, you know, it does. You wonder, like, what am I breathing all day? It fucking smells disgusting. And that place in particular, Willow Street, seemed like somebody had the bright idea, let's let 100 cats just piss down here for a year and see what it smells like. You know, and I know the actors hate it, but it usually works.
You can shoot through it and make this room a little crazier.
Okay. You're not always fortunate enough to be in a location where you're gonna be able to find anything. But when you are, I mean, why not use it? I mean, I was just walking around and saw the bunny head laying there. It was so odd and so cool. And it was, you know, it's oversized, so I knew it would look even more oversized on a poncho, which would make it even more bizarre. So I was like, I gotta use it. Does it make sense? Does it matter? No, it doesn't matter at all.
Numero cuatro! Tienes miedo! Me buscas a mí!
Open the fucking gate! I'm gonna put this fucking knife so far up your fucking ass!
Ooh, eso me gusta. I might like that.
Cut!
That's really good.
That's good. If somehow she came in here and she slid the shed, boom, and then we're in here, she goes, hides, just to give him that moment. Actually, I mean, even if it's hard to push open, that's kind of cool. And then he's like, you know, he knows there's nowhere else for you to go. He's not in the shop.
So you'll duck in there once that's shut. And I'll cue him to open this like this.
Can I do this? Can I open it?
Well, see how hard it is to open. It's kind of heavy. So
can I be like, Serena? You want me to open it all the way?
No, just a little bit's actually good. And then you don't know where she is, so you're coming in. She's probably in the closet, I'm going to figure, but...
You know. But if you want me to, like, kind of, like...
Yeah, look everywhere, because there's
enough behind there, and be like, ah. And then just kind of, like...
Stop him. Let's just test one out and see how things look.
¿Dónde estás, ah? ¿Ah? Número 5. ¡Ah!
¡Cut!
Okay.
go for it, baby.
Stab. Till I feel...
Like you...
Till you... Do you want to tell me, or should I just do it enough? Yeah.
Like five. Count five, maybe.
Okay.
You know, and then you can grab her and pull her off. And maybe you break away for something to stab one more. Like, that you don't just come right off. It's really like, what was it, Ralphie?
Yeah.
Because remember, he goes back. Like another stab. And then when you get up, BJ, you can follow when she stands back up. Stand back up. And then she can try to grab you, like, calm you down so you're all right. And that's when you can scream that thing.
Yeah.
And one, two, three, four, five.
Try.
Let go of me! And grind it in.
Yeah, and then.
Yeah. I'll slow
down.
And then
she should.
Like, I'll stand up and maybe just, like.
Then you can.
And then after maybe that last one, leave it in and pull back. And but then, you know, we don't want any huggy bits or something. So pull her back and maybe you just kind of like, you know,
okay, great,
go off
great,
on your own.
Great. Oh, good.
Like,
good,
so
good.
Like too much energy. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, I know how to get in.
And
you can spin back. But where's my fucking bat? Or something. You know,
okay.
Like you need your warrior mode.
Okay. Let go of me! My fucking back!
The bathroom set was sort of our, I mean, that was an existing bathroom, obviously. It was just white, and it was totally boring. That's probably where we spent the most time and energy on that set. So I knew it had to be significant, and there was nothing else I could find that would match it. So the art department did a really good job on that one.
This is Debbie's shot. Let's just have a look at this, fire something off on camera, and then make adjustments from there.
Eventually, this is where his face appears.
Oh my god, his face appears?
Yeah, because the door is here. He's going to go, his face under the door.
Okay.
Just, and I'll give you the cue that would be your head comes up. Just throw some lines at him. Take the shit out of him.
Go underneath. But I'm not going underneath.
No, you're just off camera just so we can have some play against.
Now look to the Polaroids and sort of just take that in. They're all the dead bodies from other times. Distant footstep. Draw back into the corner more. Closer. Stall next to you, boom. Pancho!
Hola, viejita. Soy at the door.
He's gone, but stay there. Okay, lean. Closer. You know he's coming to kill you now. Closer. More camera movement. Closer. Boom! Leave on. And cut.
That's a good one.
That seems really good.
Get him on Levon's back.
And then
We're going to bring in the stunt guys to do all the action, and then we'll see what pieces we're missing.
Good.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So that's good.
Well, they all have something in common, you know, directors do, you know? And one thing I think that Rob has... Rob has the ability to sort of like to create the space in which you can do your work, you know? And then he kind of lets you do it without much interference, you know? And then if you need some direction, you just turn to him, he'll tell you what to do, and you're like right on point.
Ready, action!
Yay! Oh, Charlie, girl, cool it with the bat. I'm on your side.
Okay.
Come on, man, give me your hand. Let's get the fuck out of here.
I had to quickly modify the fight scene, and I always feel bad because I feel like I'm stepping all over the stunt guys who, you know, they know what they're doing, but I just knew we were going to run out of time.
Wait a minute.
And maybe you had maybe come up and go,
yeah.
And you see it. Like,
boom.
Okay. She hits you.
Boom. Is he dead?
Oh, I don't know. Son of a bitch. Seems like it. I think I broke his neck.
Shit, what did he have to call?
I can't tell. I think in the shoulder blade. Take your shirt off.
Yeah, sure.
Then you take your look to him and go finish him off.
Okay.
It's funny because every time you have death scenes, you know, like I've never died, so I really don't know what it is, but I can assume what it is, and you find yourself sort of approaching it sort of just like that, you know, just based on assumption, you know, and one says, well, how do you die? Well, goddamn it, I have no idea, you know what I mean? But if the script says he goes into like a death rattle, I imagine what a death rattle would be, you know what I mean? And that is what that is. It was like I was losing my personal brother, my best friend in the world, you know, my like you see, Ace Boon Coon, my family tie. So that was a real highlight moment for me. And so I think it's a real standout, you know, one of those Showtime moments. So we'll see how it plays out, but that was really special. He is my friend, you know what I mean? And determining on when I look in his eyes and I say, Panda, you know, hey man, I think this is it. And then his response is like, no, man, it can't be it. And you go, but yeah, bro, it's over. I'm leaving.
It's gone. It's done. It's over.
And those things make up the death for me, you know, because it is a saying goodbye. And you don't want to say goodbye.
Showing up was good, you know, that was like his big Terminator entrance. And again, it was like there was this really cool elevator there. That wasn't written with an elevator in the script. I'm like, fuck, this elevator looks cool, massive, we can light it cool, fill it with these other guys and make something out of it, you know?
Roll some.
Rolling.
Exactly. Yes.
So in pieces, we should get him standing up,
grabbing for the jacket, putting on the jacket. Okay. It would be good if we're handheld, just sort of fall.
Sure.
So it's like that thing of like the boxer at the dressing room before the fight type thing.
Absolutely.
Real raging bull hand.
It's what he stole from Cassavetes.
I work with a lot of directors, but I can categorically say my favorite director to work for is Rob, and I mean that. He's amazing, and it is because it's like, hey, he's just very chilled out, very cool. But the big reason is this kind of freedom and creativity that exists. It's just inspiring.
Well, that'd be actually good if we're on your back, so when you turn around, the turn is killing you.
Yeah. And the thing that's great about it is, now what I find is this scene is just written, and then when you get in there and you're working with Wayne and you're working with Rob and you're working with costume and the other actor, obviously, or actors, is that there's just something happens and he gives his freedom to allow you to just take the scene and hopefully, you know, it seems to be the case, somehow come out with something you just wouldn't expect that's better than what was on the page.
I don't want to see me yet.
No.
So make sure we get it right, and then we get it perfect, and we turn it on. Just
kind of catch up. The camera marking.
They mark.
Picture guys, number ones.
Yeah, speed.
A work.
Mark.
Set.
Action!
Murder school? Well, it's now in session.
Even though we know he's the ringleader and he's the one that draws us together, he's the master showman, you don't ever feel like you're just following his direction. It's like he brings you in and he lets each one of you have your moment, and that's super cool. I would say he'd be like the coolest guy in the neighborhood. And whenever he comes up and says, hey, do you guys want to play a game, or do you guys want to build a fort, or do you guys want to make a film, you're like, yeah, it's Rob Zombie. He's the coolest guy in the neighborhood. Of course I'm gonna do it.
Yeah, Sick Head's bedroom was a last minute thought. I remember calling up Mike Elliott, the producer, the night before. I'm like, where can we rent a whole bunch of Nazi stuff for tomorrow morning? The funny thing is, Mike Elliott's the only person I know who never bats an eye when I say that stuff. Everyone else goes like, oh, I don't know where to go. They start panicking. Mike's like, I don't know, make a couple calls.
I wish we just had like a massive old poster, you know, like giant recruitment billboard posters.
Do we have like a half an hour or something before we're in here?
I mean, I could do it.
Probably have a half an hour before shooting.
Like a real fast.
Maybe just a real fast sloppy version of that sort of.
Yeah.
With a circle here and an eagle.
Yeah. With a slatter, yeah? No, because we need to. That's shoved too far to the wall. I want to center it up. Like I just
said. We're going to go work on it.
Yeah, go do that. I got to go look at the next set while I finish this one. You can put the TV kind of here. So it's the light hits the bed.
Okay.
That's the one good thing about being locked into one place, because at least you can get there. If they're like, oh, wait, they're all the way across town building Doomhead's apartment, then it's like, oh, boy, what am I walking into tomorrow?
Do you want the bed to be on the mattress on the floor, or should we use this? We have a frame.
I like the floor. That just is so ghetto.
Okay.
Off it, and then we'll just wire it to that piece of fence. Rolling. Action.
Okay, I think we're good.
All right,
got it. Let's move on to the next guy.
All right.
Good. I like the one.
Yeah. And then I can be over her shoulder.
Wait,
about
this?
There
we
go. What are we going
to
do? Yeah,
you have this arm straight around me.
Yeah.
Hey!
Like into birdies.
Should we get started?
Put the long arm in there?
Yeah. Getting closer.
Any more.
Set.
Okay, everybody still. Action.
Now, did you really think cutting my hair off was gonna keep me down? Oh, I got that motherfucker so back on Pancho, and I am feeling groovy!
Hey, brother! Let me over here!
You wanna see something mad funny? Oh.
Hi, everybody else in the room. Nice to meet y'all.
Hello.
I mean, Ginger Lynn was great for that role. I mean, I'd only worked with her one other time on Devil's Rejects, and I feel like both times I cast her in the same role. But she's a good actress, so she can carry it off. And I know she's not going to care about the nudity or the sex and any of that crap. That's just like whatever to her. So that's what I wanted, because I don't want, you know, sometimes if people get too hung up on that, I go, the scene's not going to, it's not going to swing. And I knew that once Ginger didn't care, Richard wouldn't care. Once she didn't give a shit, he didn't give a shit. And then you get something real good.
It's written one way, and then Rob gave a suggestion too. And then Ginger and I just kind of went for it. And we came away thinking, yeah, that scene, that definitely went somewhere completely different than what was on the page.
Yeah, yank it up. Yeah, as long as your hands are right close to the base, it's fine. I've done hair pulling 101.
And I got to, you know, have sex with Ginger Lynn, which I've wanted to do since I was 14. So, you know, that is definitely the highlight of my career. Without a doubt.
Oh, yeah! Oh, fuck you.
Don't answer that phone.
Glad I can make a young boy's dreams come true.
Thank you very much. See you tomorrow.
So this I want to directly line up with the door, so it's a straight shot.
Okay.
And then I'm probably gonna put the hand, I'm gonna bury Lou here.
Rob is a painter. I've never experienced anything like it. And this being involved here, to me, he operates on every sense in such exquisite timing and rhythm, and can make the extraordinary thing is his impulses to go this way instead of that way, to go north, south, east, or west, or over the rainbow, or into Hades. Do you know? You leap. You leap, you let go to some place that you've never planned on going. It's not only in the writing, but it is in the instant, it is in the moment that these things occur.
Yeah, that looks nice.
It's so cool.
Maybe a big blob right in the middle.
Everybody always says, I want to be in one of these movies because I want to be covered in blood and I want to do this or that. And they always do for about 5 minutes. And I'm like, no, you don't. And they're like, yes, I do. It'll be so great. And I remember Devin was like super excited in the makeup trailer when she was getting all the blood and stuff on. And then after a while, she was just miserable. Because, you know, you're strapped to this mattress, you're covered in blood, it feels like sticky and cold, you're freezing. And truthfully, even if you're laying there naked, the crew just starts to, you might as well be a tripod. They just treat you like a prop after a while.
Mark. Hey, Mark.
I'll be zooming on this one, Jason.
Okay.
Set.
Set.
Reset. Action. Oh, and we get a fucking eye. Fuck that darling little brown. Oh, and we're gonna fuck your eye holes, too.
Ah! That's no fucking doll.
Oh, Jesus. Please.
Okay.
Yeah, where are you?
Yeah,
I'm
gonna
need
extra
drugs. Thank you.
Alright, so what's going on?
Whoa.
Yeah, the blood gag worked great, you know, in the movie with the chainsaw goes between her legs, the blood's flying and screaming, you know. It's pretty convincing. MPA loved that scene. That was one of our problem spots.
Miss me?
Swipes me, we're just gonna have like a volley tip for tat for nothing. Then I'm gonna have a reaction like, what the fuck is that? Yeah, but he's got me, and then he's going, and then we go for a routine, and I'm gonna fall over him, and he's gonna go after Charlie. I'm gonna get up and kick him in his ass, and then we got the last volley until I kill him.
Okay,
And I always believe, you know, and the way I was taught, even when I was a kid studying acting up in Harlem, I'm from New York City, with the Al Fan Ensemble, is you always go the extra mile. You know, so if this is where you have to go, you go there. So for me, it's always the extra mile and a half. And you have to commit, and no matter who's around, you focus on what you have to do to get the distractions and let it happen. And to be true, some young actors sometimes ask me, they say, what is the key to acting? Is there a key? Or is there, I said, honesty. You have to be honest. You start from there, and from there, it'll come off true. Even if you're ridiculous, we'll believe it, because it's coming from somewhere.
I've always been trying to figure out with, like, who we are. Like, are we guys that he hires?
Yeah,
or are we guys who are almost like, this is like theater to us?
I think what it is, the way, look at it like that, you guys are hired to do this.
You don't give a shit.
Now that you're in this position, you just go and
say whatever.
I mean, that's your stalling tactic to try to find a way out.
Yes, it's looking better.
Yeah. Come swimming, and I duck out of the way.
Yeah.
You know, and then it's a Mexican standoff for that long.
Yeah.
You know, it's like that, and then it's like clang, 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 clang.
Yeah. I like you.
Yeah. You know, we lock each other. We hold it for a beat or two.
No.
But you know, that's, you know, he's
once
got
upon
me.
A time in the West moment.
Yeah. You know. Sergio Leone and shit. Yeah. And then we just start, you know, and he's fucked with me all the way.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, he's got.
Door,
right.
And then you hear what
screams. We're coming back to check on
them. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. Like he's like a fucking cage. Huh?
Does he come in the middle of us or
yeah.
on the side?
He comes like in the middle. Middle and splits you apart.
I do all my own stunts because the way I see it is you can be an actor or you can be a fucking pussy, you know? That guy just happens to be wearing the same thing I do. My pager's present. But if they're so focused for so long.
someone's swinging around a toy chainsaw that's not making noise. You know, it just looks so pathetic. But by the time we got it all cut together and you add in the effects and the sound effects, it's pretty intense. That scene really amazingly came together.
So we'll make it a pretty big shirt slice, but maybe it only hit flesh real deep.
Okay.
So it didn't get, you know.
Into Lynn's with it.
A real chainsaw spinning and cutting sharp blade, the whole thing.
Yeah, well, it doesn't have to be a sharp blade, but it has to be a turning blade.
So it's just the turning one, it's the rubber blade. Yeah,
bring the dummy back towards me.
The dummy we had to chop the head off of, strangely enough, was Richard Brake's dummy from Halloween 2. We're always just recycling things from other movies. But yeah, trying to make that dummy work in such short notice, and I mean, now it works great, you know, but it was always tricky, you know. It's graphic enough to have an impact, but it's not lingering enough that it becomes like comedy.
I was just this to show it.
Let me put my hand in there, tell me if that works. If I'm like,
Yeah, that does work.
Oh, yeah, so struggle with it like it's caught on the fucking vertebrae.
Yeah, you have to be, you know, and then Robin, if you can give us a cue, then I can pull the head and then Larry will know to follow through.
I'll sit right here.
Okay.
That's over, so you just drop the bad guys. Rolling.
Set.
Hand up. Hands up, and Larry, whenever, go for it. Action.
Okay, brother.
Perfect. Moving on. So we'll have to reset for that.
Yes, sir.
When Jeff hits his leg,
do I need?
Oh, would there be blood on?
When Jeff hits his leg, I'm gonna widen out, and then you drop the chainsaw.
Drop and gun.
Yep.
Do you want? Am I already here?
You're there, and you just come down with the hands.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, lock it down. Here we go.
Happy that we didn't really see any blood in the chainsaw. There was no blood in the chainsaw. Like, we didn't see anything.
It leaked us.
It started to.
Yeah, we didn't see anything.
I'm just a puppet.
Hey, Rob, did you see Robert? Did you guys see enough blood?
I'm just a puppet.
Did you see enough blood in the chainsaw?
No. I didn't see anything.
Should we do it again?
No. No. We've run out of time. Just got to do the same thing as I'm seeping to that fucking floor.
All right, so.
What if we cheated the Lou off of one of the valves and had it squirt up on the one side?
Well, maybe.
Hey, Bart.
What about
the way that
CG
happens
blood?
When he's laying down, is it a way to get it so we can just see one side of the blood coming up from the chainsaw? Because I think he was blocked. Something happened where he just blocked the blood.
Oh, I would think if we cheated it.
If we cheated to one side, right?
All right.
Yeah, I mean, we're ready. We're right here.
All right. So why don't you lay down?
Get a close up and just shove the camera in there.
That's good. Close up, insert.
I will never fucking die!
That was fucking rad.
here, you can shoot from there, shoot from here. And then you can shoot from here too.
We can shoot from here.
Yeah.
The pussy doors were like, that was our only true, one of our true sets where we built it from scratch. Yeah, and they were, I mean, right on the other side of those doors when we were shooting a chainsaw fight while they were building. And I thought that actually looks great on camera. When I first saw it finished, I didn't think it was dirty enough. I didn't think they had put in enough detail. But, you know, when it was all said and done with the paint job and everything, you know, it really came to life and it really looks totally believable.
Even in the conversation, it's really just visual. But it looks this way and just
yep.
not stress over it.
Yep.
That would be
yep.
the best
just
thing.
Relaxed and we're not, we're still
just,
looking for them.
Yeah,
listening.
Because that's here. True. But just walking around the corner and seeing a great big pussy and great big legs and shoes.
Right.
Yeah, I'm going. I'm just going to put on by.
So that line could be on more harder.
I don't know.
I'm going to stop it. That crank.
Nobody should walk on it. Who would walk on it?
Wait, I'll try to.
Set!
I'm gonna reach her a couple times, but then I wanna like taunt him a little, but I can't talk because he's talking the whole time and there's a chainsaw. So it's just gonna be coming
out. Yeah, it'll be like just a little.
Yeah. Jeff's character as Roscoe kept changing. You know, in the first version of the script, his character was weaker. I mean, many things were different, but that character. And I kept wanting to enhance his character. I went back and made his side of the fight more aggressive for him. You know, because when Lou was there, it was more dominating. Like, oh, Lou's in charge, and he's, you know, and Jeff's the total victim. And I wasn't really digging that, so I went back and shot that stuff with just Jeff and Meg to pump up his character, to make him tougher, make him more in the fight, not just a victim.
Let's just come up with a line. Then. I don't think it needs to be too big.
No, just like, you know, like, come on, chainsaw down, let's fucking do it. You know, like
put it down.
Or something like, oh, you're tough with a chainsaw. Tough, you know, like, fucking bash your head in. I mean, it's kind of a fucking chainsaw. How much of a puss can he be, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Might as well have a gun.
Yeah. When he first told me about this project about, probably about a year ago, he described, he goes, so your character, he's an illustrator, and he's a single father, and he started telling me about all the characters, how they're going to be taken from their lives. And what, and then I opened the script and it was five carnies in an RV get kidnapped. So obviously he's not held to any idea that if he sees something going better another way, he just runs with it, which that happens on the set all the time. You know, every morning you're like, wait a minute, that's not the script that I had last night.
God damn it, I knew it! I knew it!
He's dead!
It's a fucking cage! Panda! The gate came out of nowhere!
Bring it on, man. Bring it on.
You boys like to squeal like pigs, don't you? Aye! Aye! Come on! Come on!
Kill Billy Crack.
Very nice. That was awesome.
That was great. Moving on. That was killer.
Guys, to the basement.
You could just have the hazer kind of.
You want me to hit the hazer from there as opposed to down here and that'll even you out?
That's what I'm talking about.
Action!
I don't hear them anymore.
Me neither.
Out.
I second the barricade idea. You got to use your head. You don't want us to be sitting all night on our backside. Okay, hold on. Charlie, we haven't heard you in the last half an hour. What are you saying? Huh? Your vote counts like mine.
I say we hunt these freaks down and slit their fucking throats.
You guys will both come running up. The doors will be slightly ajar. Doors are kind of like that.
And I think you're like, we gotta find something to secure these doors.
You're hearing chainsaws.
Okay.
We'll fix that.
Am I saying that?
Do I say we gotta? I think that would have been your line. We gotta find something to secure these doors or whatever.
That's cool.
And then
help me find something.
No. We gotta find something to help us.
How about one of these pipes?
Pacal. And then I'm gonna slam it in here.
Okay.
Wait, can I
fit? It'll fit. It will fit. Yeah, we did it already.
Okay. And then how long do you think it'll hold?
But if you give yourself a beat and he's ahead of you, like,
okay. No, and you're right.
I'm going to say no, and be gone, and then you take your moment, and you're gone.
Can you at least lie to me?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, alright.
We got to get something to knock off the door!
Got one of these pipes? Think it'll hold?
No.
That was a last-minute gag that I just thought of, you know, wasn't in the script, Wayne wasn't prepared for it, but then we just thought, oh, why don't we do it, you know? And it worked fine, you know, once it was all said and done and went through post, we fixed it, it looks great.
Cut. I think that's as good as we're gonna. Nice, thank you, David.
I just want you to note how glamorous the Hollywood lifestyle is. At the end of every day, I get two men massaging me with shaving cream. It's fucking great, man. It was a memorable one.
It was.
I mean, he's a great director to work with. He's like, at the table read, he came up to me and he goes, "You speak fluent Japanese?" I said, "Yeah." He goes, "We gotta get that in the movie." Which is, you know, that was like the best thing anybody could say to me. And then I came up with some ideas for how to do it and he was like, "Yeah, let's do it."
Done 8 movies together. We've worked together 8 days.
He's in everything, but never for that long, which is kind of funny.
I have worked with him repeatedly, and I love every moment of it. Every moment of it. I also write some of his music.
I don't want to do this because it's too low. I think what I want to do is perfectly straight and he walks perfectly just this.
Uh-huh.
You know, not low because then
Sure.
I want him to talk directly into camera.
Gotcha. Like, I love the idea. What I would like to do is like the screen's totally black and then it's just no, and then the only light is the door.
It might be cool, might not be cool.
Yeah, it's really easy to just turn off these lights.
Some episodes put this behind him like this.
Good.
I don't think we'll see him, so if we can just give him something so he can hold his hands behind him, that'd be pretty cool. His chest is over here.
No.
That could be bad. Oh my god. Poltergeist will tell you that too.
Yeah.
This is the most around.
Yeah, Richard's great. I knew he was unconventional because he's not this big, scary presence. He looks like he weighs about 120 pounds. But I knew it didn't matter because I knew he could really take those words and make something out of it. Nobody wanted Richard. Everyone fought me on it to the last second. You just gotta push through, tell everybody what they want to hear, and then do whatever the fuck you want. And then at the end, they're like, oh my god, Richard Brake is genius in that role. Like, yeah, no one seems to remember that. You know, all the guys high-fiving are the ones that said that absolutely do not cast him, but whatever. He's there.
What I did is just basically go into a space of some very dark things that must be inside me. So I don't know where it is or where it comes from. I probably don't want you for everyone to know, but so that's where Doomhead resides. So I have to go into that little dark corner and find it. Yeah. It's what keeps me sane.
They call me Doomhead.
Now, Mr. P.T. Barnum may claim clowns are the pegs on which this circus is hung, but I ain't no fucking clown.
I should apologize in advance for not sharpening this thing. It might take a couple of extra whacks.
Listen to me. Listen to me, please. I'm begging you. I'm begging you. You don't have... You don't have to do this.
You know what they say, King Sabi? Well, everybody loves popcorn.
I'm done. They made a mistake. I'm done.
Wait, I really am done?
Wait, Lynn? They had no traditional fibers flopping.
Is it gonna flash?
Probably.
What day?
Oh, no, you're getting remade up.
You gotta kill some more people. That's fucked up.
Listen, you know, I mean, I hate to say it's over, but it is over. I really do hate to say that, but it was great as always.
It was nice to get outside just because I was always afraid the movie was gonna become too dark and too claustrophobic after a while, and it would go from, oh, this is scary and weird, to like, oh, this is getting monotonous. And that was also the great day when I found out one of our camera operators decided to not show up for some bullshit reason, and he had been replaced. Luckily, he had been replaced with somebody that was actually better, but that is always nice.
But that looks pretty damn good.
No, it looks good. It just was...
Yeah, make sure those pads don't show.
Quiet, please! Shh.
Very noisy down there for a second. Just get up.
Looking behind you a few times.
Out that time.
Okay.
Right there in the grass on the side. And that's why I've told the crew is if anyone needs to go anywhere where they can't see the ground, just give me a call, we'll go through first.
And when you get to here, veer off towards that.
Yeah, that ending I changed a million times. I mean, that was one of those things during shooting when I made the marionette show at the end, the same one that was at the gas station. That was never in the script.
Alright, cool. Spin it. Alright, let's go to one.
Guys, may I clear everyone out of the house, please?
Yeah. Come through here, butt up against here like this, you know?
Yeah.
And then peel through.
Okay, Dad, I'd like to keep her on this side.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good.
That's good.
You're good. All
right, talk about guys.
Action!
Number five, Lou.
I start talking, do you want it to fill out?
Yeah, I think when you're like
dazed, trying to come to.
Okay. It's a lot of bullshit to deal with too. It's like, that's when, for actors, like, I feel bad because, like, you know, it's like, okay, you got to give this totally, but you can't really move this. You got to hold your head like this. You can't, you know, your microphone's hidden here. This blood tube's running here. I forget. Like, you know, I just, you know, you're watching the monitor assuming they're going to be great. Let's do it.
Everybody settle. Everybody set.
Set.
I always thought I'd appear rather pretentious with a pipe.
Can we cut?
The blood is just running down the side of her face and I can't see any of it. And I can give a second action when I see it. And then he can start his lines. Wake up.
If that helps, let's do it.
Let's do it that way.
Because this position sucks.
I'd give a second action for your lines. No, it's hard. Because, you know, they get to a certain point where it's like anything else. They're ramping up to it, and you can see they're right there. That's as hysterical as they're going to get. That's as upset or whatever. And then when it doesn't work, you start seeing now they had the real moment where it was happening, and then you start coming down the mountain.
I'm going to get up as soon as this tube is out.
Okay. I mean, I feel bad for actors. I mean, the whole movie hinges on the actors. If the actors can't bring it, you're watching horse shit. You know, I always want to protect what they need. It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter if it sounds fucking crazy. If that's what they need to get the job done, that's what they fucking need.
Look into the eyes of a true champion. Look into the eyes of a true champion. Look into the eyes of a true champion.
So, why can we do it from
in a little bit of the ending, and then you go, motherfucker, and standing up.
I just, you know what I mean?
That I can handle.
Michael Alcott, I worked with him one time on Devil's Rejects. He came in and plays the guy who was selling the chickens, the chicken fucker guy. And fans always really loved him. Again, it's a short, tiny thing, but he's memorable. So that's all that matters.
You know, I didn't bring you here to not be funny.
Do you, man. Bring
all right,
shit.
I can get any of you to drive this thing.
All right, cool,
I'm
man.
I'm here because you're funny.
No, okay. Cool.
No, this is my second time with Rob, man. Devil's Rejects. Bam, the chicken fucker salesman came alive. So from there, Fat Randy coming alive.
We like Fat Randy. We're gonna feel bad when he dies.
But when we're in a scene, never make eye contact with me.
Sound like
who does that?
All the fat things you see from the South—that's what I am. You know, no underwear under the overalls. You know, shit's really fucked up.
You're not supposed to deal with the rent to own shit. This is some inferior equipment I got here.
Got you. Is that what Liz got? Trust me, my equipment is working fine.
I'm trying to get my mind on it. I mean, what do you think about the new talent? I can't exactly figure out if the one with the lopsided high beans drunk when she retired.
honestly, does it really fucking matter? She's gonna twitch and itch her ass around the midway like all the babies do.
That's why I'm afraid, man. There's a whole new wave of crap coming on strong. They say on the midway, they got some sweet Rasta shit. Charlie got some sweet Rasta shit.
Sure, you can dance.
Oh, my sweet Charlie, past the boys I hit.
Aye, and I'm on, baby.
And
anyone see a pair of it?
Michael, are you sitting on your pack right now?
Can you,
Sheri,
when you turn this way, if you sort of put your weight back
on. I need some space too, Hazan. You're right in my shot now.
This isn't bad.
It became a low rider because, you know, six actors and six crew or ten crew, and it was like a scene from Night at the Opera in the stateroom.
If you guys high five down here, it's better. We see it. Up here, you kind of
roll.
Yeah.
I do like that.
Yeah, like one of those.
Let's slide it off. Holy! I think my dick just got double hard.
Aye.
You put them on your head and push some of your hair back with them on the sides.
Okay, well.
How am I supposed to work with this inferior goddamn equipment?
Is that what the ladies are calling it now?
Trust me, my new alley is working fine. Hey, look a boy. If this monster break out here in the ass in the nowhere, you're gonna get your loud ass out there and you're gonna push with the bumper up your ass.
We made it.
Bathroom scene is in here somewhere, right?
No, it's actually
a different place.
There's the bathroom. There isn't one. So the bathroom scene, there's a farmhouse over there. That actually has a bathroom. It looks like,
okay, looks like the shit.
A restroom bathroom. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I'm going to shoot it over there, actually.
Can I can sit in back here.
Tracy Walter came in to play Lucky Leo, and he was great. Seems very authentic, you know. Fucked up teeth, fucked up attitude. Wacky as hell.
Do you want something
good,
to drink?
Good. I'm over on the
couch. Do you need water?
No, I'm ready to shoot.
Okay, all right, yeah,
yes.
Me too.
Thank you for
stopping
over.
Of course, darling.
Let her be somebody else's queen. I don't want to know about it. Too many others have heard that scene. I don't want to hear about it. I'm in love with a girl. I'm thinking about it. I'm in love with a girl. I can't live without it.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it right there
with
this sort of walking right now.
From this great world, to choose a token that all is wrong in heaven would love.
I love when she steps down, that's when you can stand up and come to meet her. Until then, it's just a show.
Thank you. Slate's in. Roll some.
Action! A soft song fell within his hearing. He picked our girl.
You can call me Leo. Lucky Leo, if you know what I mean.
That was another last minute idea that I had that wasn't in the script originally. That came from one night I was rehearsing with Jeff and Sheri. We were just sort of going through some stuff and we started talking about those moments because I wanted every character to have a moment at the gas station. And I thought, oh, it would be kind of cool to bring one of those characters into that. And I thought she'd be the best one.
Set.
Set.
Hey, sailor. How many seamen you got in that tin can?
Too many. Why, any left?
Maybe. I could fit in very tight spaces.
I bet you can.
See you later, Papa. I'm gonna go get me some spinach.
I was trying to give him some butt crack. I'm going to add some little lower.
Whoa! It's frying in the sun.
We're not listening to what he says. We're going to shoot it. B camera will take the van. They'll shoot tight on the sign, pan over, the van comes through. They'll give us the van. The first thing we'll do with the van is we'll do a following the van with the hood mount. Two cameras on the hood mount, a wide and a tight, and we'll do it at different distances all the way down the road. And we'll turn around and come back different distances all the way down the road. On the ass end of the last shot, we'll slow down and just let it go off into the wilderness.
You'll be able to do all that within 1 hour, I hope.
I mean, starting
in 1 hour.
We don't have the same tastes
we could have been.
That you have.
Okay, holding on that. That's nice. Let the flare more as she moves. And cut!
We went then used the house for the bathroom of the gas station. Yeah.
That's great. That's great. All right. Here, so if he's like this.
Yeah, that's plenty.
And they're just like that. Mm-hmm.
That was a good little scene we needed. I mean, like I said, everybody just needed their one human moment at the gas station because I was like, I knew we had sort of established everybody in the RV, but I'm like, we still don't know who everybody is and how they feel. And, you know, 5 minutes from now, they're all going to be trapped in horror, so we better find some broad strokes where we can get these guys in a groove.
You guys ready? We're ready, Gabe.
He wrote an idea of a person, and so the person has something that he wants to say. And you have to find a way to make it your own. You know, when you're being an actor, that's my take on it. I mean, you base it on your own sensibilities anyway as an actor, and then you create from there. That's the stair step in being an actor. And so I just put a lot of elements. I mean, with the West Indian culture, that was taking it somewhere else. The superstitious thing that just came, you know, and we kind of both went with it. My character would sing a song and go into the West Indian thing and start singing a song. I sang some of my dialogue. You know, you find different ways to make it creative, you know, more interesting for an audience.
Seriously, though, it looks like I'm losing my shit. I don't know me this much for you.
Hey, man, partner. As much as I like hanging out in here with you, smelling my dingleberries and talking about your love life with your hairline, I'm going back to the big bitch boss, so follow me this way, much.
Do it! Roll camera! Roll camera!
1,000 miles an hour.
Well, I told them to go.
But now we got a big cloud of dust.
You want to shoot it coming back?
Shoot him coming back.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, camera!
Speed!
Speeding.
Set.
All right, that looks good. Let's do it. The guys are hiding here.
Don't you want them to kind of come from behind them?
Well, yeah, that's true. So if, say, where Josh is, the scarecrows
exactly.
are sort of there.
Hey,
What has really informed my decisions on some of those things has been living on the East Coast. Those dark, foggy nights, even though, you know, it gets foggy here and whatever. But in that way, I had never would never see them. So when we'd go to shoot something, I would think, oh, it doesn't look real. That's too foggy. Let's do this and that. And by having lived on the East Coast, I'd go outside and I'd like walk the dog or something, and it'd be so foggy, and you just see these weird beams of light coming from street lights or the moon. You go, this looks so rad. It's totally real, and it looks so staged right now. So now when we go do stuff at night, it's like, yeah, find those light sources, really pump it full of fog. And even though it seems like it looks totally phony, it looks completely genuine to me, and I think it helps it come to life more.
So you're sprawled out there, so you would get up, go out.
I get up.
You follow him. You follow him first, because you'll be sitting here. Meg will be on the inside playing cards. You'll be sitting next to her. And you go out, and you're like, how can
we? Action!
What the hell is this?
So let's go back inside the RV, clean that up, then we'll come out and start shooting.
That night, when we finally needed the RV, it wouldn't run. It drove into place and died. That was great. So you're just working around. But again, you can't fix it in time because someone had put, I guess it had two gas tanks and someone gassed up the wrong one. I don't know what the story was, but somebody didn't know what was happening. And by that point, it was like 20 below zero and everybody was freezing that night, so nobody cared anymore.
Shit. What the fuck is this shit?
He's here somewhere.
So he's gonna come around. He's like the second one. He hasn't quite noticed yet.
Boom! He's gonna grab him.
Snap the leg.
Like that.
Right. Well, originally there was gonna be a lot of squib work and gunfire and stuff, but I 86'd all that because I just knew we're never gonna get through this.
So, Goons, let's step out over here.
Take it through. He's gonna grab you like that.
Step. She's out quickly.
Yep. She's out. Bang, down. We'll take you through this action here. He's gonna grab you around the neck.
Get up there.
Voodoo schmoodoo.
Let's move this stuff off. What the fuck?
Cut!
Got to die on screen for the first time, and it was kind of cool. There was like blood in my mouth. I had to cough it up. I had to like be dragged by some crazy goons, and it was fun. It was super duper fun.
I'm wondering if you should be on the other
side. Hang on a sec, guys.
We did not have enough time to do what we needed to do. It was freezing cold.
It's late. People are cranky.
That's
700.
There just shouldn't be any people back here looking through.
Sorry, boss. Do you think maybe a solid mark? Sorry. All right, so next up, the top five, gagged and bound.
Rob is incredible. Oh my gosh, his vision and his direction, just, you know, he knew exactly what he wanted, and he could communicate to us so easily, and just we just got it, you know. He let us try different things, so just to even be in a production like this is such an amazing opportunity.
Here comes. I got it.
Cam speed.
Hey, Mark.
All right, the buddies, get ready to hold still. And I'm going to count you down. Deep breaths. 3, 2, 1.
Well, I'd say all good things got to come to an end, and this is the end of the line for us today.
You'll be down there. That's when you'll wake up.
Come up these
stairs. But that's too many words.
I'm talking wrong. Say that way, you know, something like that. I'm just saying. Say something.
Nobody was this way. Hmm? Or we hear something, or whatever. I mean, that's always been driven.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, that's what people should have been running around.
Do we hear
him? We can make that the motivation to leave.
That's even better. Yeah. So we hear sound coming from where?
Because now it looks like there's all these levels. So you could look up.
Moving to AES was kind of a bitch because you kind of get into a groove in a location that, and once again, you're like, how do we make this place look good? You know, because you just get used to a place, you know how to light it and how to where to put the camera to exploit it. And I think we probably got off to a slow start that day because it was just tricky trying to figure it out.
Yeah, but see, yeah, just hug the wall. Lose right. That battery.
Yeah, all that's gone
away. All right.
Yeah.
You're pushing it.
Sound of a snake. Mm-hmm. How's this look? Does that make much difference?
Yeah.
Can I see it real quick?
Yeah, hold on.
And this is one of the first shots.
That tends the way to do it.
This will be the first big shot in the factory, so. All right.
Okay. Yeah.
Excuse me, but you're acting a lot.
No, you go fuck yourself.
Enough!
I'm sick of this
enough.
Shit. Fuck you, man.
Enough.
I go into the zone, you know, and I kind of, you know, lock in, but that's my way of weeding everything out and just concentrating on what I have to do. I tell you, years ago when I was a kid in New York, I used to work at the Public Theater, and I got to watch, just before Al Pacino became a star, I got to watch him rehearsing a play, and he was like that. You know, and people like that, it came from that old method acting school, those Morgan Freemans who was down there as well, or way before that with Sidney Poitier or Marlon Brando. You get into that moment and you have to let it come true for you, and you have to let it build, then you unleash it, you know, and you let it go where it's going, you let the instincts take over, and it happens, so that's my thing. So it doesn't matter who's around me, nobody can shake me.
You had to quickly, very quickly, there's no rehearsal, create like this family thing. Even though our personalities are quite different, everybody kind of had to have a certain respect and collaborative, familia type feeling, the Carney thing, and it seemed to really work.
And that's not always the case, too, on films, but we all have a certain amount of respect, and, you know, I think it comes across. And there's, like, you know, everybody's watching each other's back, and that's what this film's about.
When you come around here, you can actually see it. And then we got into the thing of some of the great locations at AES were actually exteriors that I was cheating for interiors, which actually worked out great, but at the time was like, well, once again, now we're back outside in the freezing cold.
We could give you one further up here. You want to break up the ground?
Sure. It's a background step for you, sir. Put it here.
Okay, cool. Are we putting it on track?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus. All right, great.
You ready?
Yep.
All right, guys. Thanks for that, Mr. Light.
Okay, good.
All right,
good.
Are we ready?
Yeah.
A little bit less.
Can we come across?
Oh, I slipped.
I felt the blade last time.
I'll do what you
just
did. It was cool.
Okay. Ready, boys?
Action!
Johnny.
Cut. That was great.
Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you, guys.
It's a wrap.
We are doing Roscoe getting all dead and stuff, and this very intimate scene between Roscoe and Charlie.
I think that we should probably rip off pieces of his shirt for the rags, because these conveniently placed rags might be too much. Like maybe the sleeves are ripped off and they ripped off the bottom of this, and this is what she's wrapped around his arm or something.
Okay. Well, I'm going to start down here, and then when you come into it, are you
going
to come in, like, fast or
slow?
Yeah.
You can run and
better
get out fast.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
You know, you come in, you say what's your name? You say you better get up, something's happening.
It's going down.
Whoa. Stay where you want.
Yeah, this is
Oh.
Yeah,
give it a longer thing.
Okay, can I pick up my crowbar though? Like I'm ready, but I can't get it? Or
yeah, whatever. I just want to make sure they're gone and we hang on you like, what's he going to do? Like, and then I can give you a cue if you get it. Like, you plop down. Just like, not like fighting, but I mean like,
whoa,
you're not going anywhere. Fuck that, I'm not.
Yes.
You know, or whatever. Just another beat of that is good before they take off.
Okay.
Sound speed?
Oh, man.
B-mark.
How fucked am I?
I don't know, man. Looks pretty bad.
Yeah, it feels pretty bad.
Are you saying that you're on ground level?
I think we should go on the 10 for this.
Okay. You want to be down that low?
Maybe. I mean, it's all, everything right now is about making this place
big. Okay. Hey, be able to get us to here. Okay. And then track straight back.
Roscoe came out of here somewhere,
do you want the font to push this way or this way?
It'd be better to push this way. It looks better.
So where am I going? I'm going
to I think it will. You should hang. They're going to bolt and we'll hang on you, and then we can cut.
So we come down the stairs, run along here.
Yeah.
Panda does his line, and then Meg and I run out.
Which way do we go?
Where do we go?
We're going to, let's see.
Well, through there.
Yeah, right.
I mean, you'll be in tight, and you guys can just peel back the way you came.
We'll I think that's best.
You know, we'll just lose you going back this way.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
like
maybe.
This is like, as if this is the in and out of everywhere.
Exactly.
Okay.
just can to keep it simple.
Can we have Panda kind of peeking out so we can see them
be
in
doing,
the foreground and then see them in the background?
Yeah, he's here peering around.
Can we see him do it
once? You want to run it once?
Yeah.
Back to
once. Going to run it once.
I'll create that distraction. We're only going to get one shot. See, I'll make it proper.
Crazy on the first one, crazy on the second. I think this one's getting a little crazier, so I think this one, right? The other one was really crazy too. I like working with Bill, but this one... Yes. And I get to have a lolly.
Lost looks, girls.
Terrorizing with German.
Sheri.
Yes.
Just throw it straight to me like.
Like this?
Like they hit. Watch me. There you go. See that?
Okay.
Yeah.
What?
Boom, boom. Every time.
One more time.
You're so pro.
Thank you.
Time up, guys. Let's see what you got.
Come here! Come here! Save me!
Fire!
Du kleine dreckige Mistsau, ich werde dich zerdrücken. Wie gefällt dir das, ha? Ha, du Stückchen Scheiße. Ha?
Oh, how nice. The women are here to save the day.
Come on.
Come, ladies, come here.
Panda. Panda.
Come, come! I want to fuck you!
This is super simple. I'm gonna get you over here with Larry. It's when one of the announcements goes off. If you just whisper something to her, and then you can exit, because he's probably says, go get him. You know, we don't even have to hear you.
Yeah. All right, guys, rehearsal's up. Hold the work, please.
Attention. Attention. Number one, odds 40-1. Number two, odds 300-1. Number three, odds 1,000,000-1. Number five, odds 300-1. Sex and death are on their way.
What you're doing is you're shortening here. You do a wrist. Just kind of extend the arm to slap. That's it. That's it.
Okay, that makes a difference.
Just more consistent, so it's more controlled. That's it. That's it.
Okay.
Oh, that's the one.
Yeah, it's a
see, because you're drawing him in. You're drawing him in, and then you're like,
yeah, I got you.
Like that, right?
There we go.
All right, here we go. We're set.
Cameras.
Action!
Hi! Maybe I should really put you out of your misery.
What about in preceding that? Is it okay, or we gotta do it? We'll start from the beginning.
Well, let's just do a pickup on this here, and then we'll.
Yeah, and just when we did it, your hand was like this. I need to be able to, let me have two slices here.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Yeah, yeah. Okay,
good. Can you guys turn back up?
Yeah, with the lights there, we can just line.
And then just remember the arms like this. Like this, we got it. And just don't
Yeah, they don't even have to be that violent. They just have to be a lot
Move
closer.
A little more. Yeah, I can't, yeah.
All right, so down EG, start struggling. Sheri!
Oh my gosh, did I hit your face? It's okay, don't worry. It's okay.
Okay, how'd that look? I can't really see you.
How'd that look? Cool.
Okay.
Yeah, the strobe.
Yeah, good thing we did that. It's trippy. That.
Okay.
We're bouncing between here and there. And when we're here, we can see the bat toss. So it's going to cheater more this way.
Okay, cool.
Don't go too far this way. I want to try to make you look a lot bigger and look down on her. So the more you're closer to me here, the better it is to make you look. Do you want me to move freely? Do you want me to stay close to this area? I mean, do what you were doing before. Beforehand, we actually stalked each other for like a full circle. What do you want to do, Rob?
Kind of keep doing this. You know,
okay. Yeah,
and because it's really just to feel you in the foreground and her down here. It doesn't really have to. We can make it match to the
dance. Yeah.
So it's really every time.
Yeah. While you're spinning.
Sights in. Roll sound.
Of course. Make it
hectic. All right. Sit.
Set. Action.
Yep.
Kill you this. Thing is so heavy.
Got it.
Well, Torsten's character was kind of tricky. I mean, I feel like it all worked out great at the end of the day, but that one I always felt was the least figured out before we started shooting, because there was no time to really change it.
Right now we have this stunt going, but you haven't like laid down any vibe on what your personality is going to be, so now we're like I'm staring at that and it doesn't mean anything to me. Like, it has to work backwards from you.
That's right.
Yeah, let's go around to the set where we're going to do this, just to see like how you're going to sound, what it's going to be.
This is all about your big build-up and your approach and the way you're gonna enter. So we should all, where's Dave?
Yeah.
So we'll go down to the end and watch how he's gonna approach.
Yeah, exactly.
Leckere kleine Fotzen, ich werde euch die Titten abschneiden, dann werde ich euch ficken! 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 Ha 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 ha! Nice! How do you like that, huh?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Oh, yeah.
And then you get distracted doing that, and that's when he sneaks up on you and fight begins.
Setup and then you have a payoff. So if you don't have a setup and you just have a payoff, you know, where I'm crying about, you know, my sweetheart, then it doesn't tell the same as if we have like that setup where you kind of get, oh, there's some weird relationship going, and then she dies and suddenly the bad guy turns and is devastated, gets killed by the good guys. I like that. I don't know how it works in the end, but Rob kind of let us go there, or he went there with us, you know, perfect. It's not a very big role, but to find these specifics in small roles like that, very important.
Doch die Mama weinet sehr.
Doch die Mama weinet sehr.
Hat ja nun kein Händchen mehr.
Ach, doch nun kein Händchen mehr.
Da besinnt sich das Kind. Kommt noch rausgeschwänzt.
Baby.
Death strikes once, and then it's gone!
By that point, Roscoe's character was supposed to be dead, but I decided to keep him alive because I liked what was happening. And Meg had this big kind of monologue, and at that point I was like, you know what? I don't want to hear anyone else talk. I just want a visual of what's left of them, and I'm going to play it against something. And it works great. because that's the last scene you see of them before Doomhead's big entrance. And it's kind of sarcastic, too, because it's like playing over the speakers as if, like, you know, Malcolm's character is giving them, like, here, enjoy the music while we wait for Doomhead to arrive. Again, spur-of-the-moment thing. I'm sure everybody was pissed because people rehearse their lines and have these big moments, but it just works out better. It's more memorable.
You get that feeling that you're making something special?
Yeah, definitely. It's not like this. I mean, I work enough where, you know, you get your paycheck, you have a good time, but people know these zombie fans are fanatics for this, and there's a reason we all kind of enjoy that world he builds and their collaborative relationships, and I don't know, it doesn't come around that often, especially in Hollywood.
Where's Johnny?
She went down the hall to see what she could find.
You let her go out on her own?
Like I was gonna stop her?
Look. You idiot.
When he goes, then yeah. I just stay there.
Yeah, he's gonna like, it's as if it's here,
go here,
dragging
and then,
up. Yeah.
But the whole time he's talking, is he dragging up on you?
No, you're not talking.
So he goes like this, and then he goes sayonara and goes up.
I could do it that I talk, you know, I say, take solitude that all end at the hands of a master, sayonara, and then do it. Or could do it.
We could do the sayonara as you cut it, because it's kind of like very carry.
Yeah.
Let's do that.
Too. Yeah.
What's that?
Okay. Action, Meg!
Charlie?
The back will just already have it rigged.
So
he'll just take his hand off the rig and we'll see it's there.
Yeah, that one.
And then the front will get the pad. But then once we switch to the half, could he hide a thing there in his hand? And
I'm just going to run to the trailer and grab a couple things.
Yeah, cool. Yeah, then we can just be done with inserts on that one.
So like start the blade all the way out like that.
Start it out.
Yeah,
come in.
Boom. Yeah. And then. I think we can get away with it. So start out and action.
Well, that was the easiest money I ever made.
So maybe let her top lip one side, like, smooch that out so she loses the shape. Give her one right in the mouth. Shut the fuck up. Bam. I wish we had a fat lip.
Would that be good?
Maybe you could stick something under here so it looks swollen.
Yeah.
The Sheri and Deathhead scene was really good. That turns out to be really strong in the movie. I'm glad we did it like that. I mean, her character had been transitioning from wimpy to strong through the whole movie, but that was the final, like, you know, she slits her, she's standing there, and you're like, okay, here's our warrior that we're gonna have to the end. You know, I used to do things a little more loose, so it always felt real, and I've been getting a little more into composing the shots, like make sure you stand just like that, you have your hero shot.
Yeah. And then, you're not gonna give me a second action, I'll just do it when she's done screaming. Okay.
And that's when you can start.
Great.
13.
God, that felt bloody.
That looked good.
The nice thing is that there's a lot of space to improvise. That, you know, the script that he wrote is a blueprint for him. So he, you know, if you come up with something that he likes, he is very, very easygoing about that. And that's fantastic for an actor, you know, because I see something there, you know, I think it should be a little bit exacerbated or going there. And he always goes, yeah, 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 you know, do that. And actually that reminds me a little bit of, I worked on the Coen Brother movies, The Big Lebowski. And if they liked something, they said, ah, more of that, you know, or less of that, you know. So you had a lot of space, you know. And in a way, I think Rob has pretty much a vision about what he likes, but he gives you space, you know. Any good director is doing that, you know, giving you space.
All right, guys, morning. Welcome to the last day of the film.
I wanted to create a montage of them driving cross country. When I came out to California from East Coast to shoot the movie, I shot footage all the way across country with my phone, you know, with an app that looks like Super 8 and it's completely believable. So when it came time to shoot that, I figured, well, I already know it looks good what I'm shooting, even though, you know, BJ was shooting with a better camera, I just shot it with my phone and that's what I use. Never have a second unit because it's never time to control it, you know, and you can't just send somebody off, oh, go shoot all this, and it comes back going, well, that doesn't make it match anything. But for inserts, it's fine.
You just want to stay within this thing.
Okay.
I mean, you're not going to be using the real knife. You're going to have the half knife and just kind of grinding it here while okay. Pumping the blood out. But just so you know where your safe zone is.
Jesus, not again.
Pancho, I'll give you a second action.
Okay.
Okay, action Kevin, you're kind of calm. Ah! All right. And Pancho, go. Ah! 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 The knife. Ah! Go to Kevin's face. Ah! Pancho.
I'm ready.
Go to the knife.
I'm ready.
Up. Get some. Guys can move a little less. Okay, and cut. Now you've cut blood. Cut it.
The first time?
No, I think we got it. It was a pretty simple thing, and that was it.
Very good.
Any more blood, everyone's going to float away. What's the next thing? Because at that point, it was like in the back of the guy's head, and then she like pulled it out. So she just have a little bit of pulling out motion.
Leave it on here, and then just kind of swing it back in. Like,
yeah. Yeah, something like that. Action. And pull.
Yeah, we'll see how far we get. Yeah.
I want to finish this by lunch. I don't want to be done.
That would be great.
You want to try a strap?
Or some sort of underlying instrument.
We haven't done that yet.
I think so.
Yeah.
I'm saying even without the fights, I think this is a giant scene.
It doesn't have to be though. They walk in, they have no dialogue, they go to him and he talks.
Yeah.
If I'm juggling with this bullshit,
it definitely is.
Okay, I'm stripping it out.
Hey, good. Good.
Very good.
I see the scowler.
Scowler.
Go ahead and squirt some of that. Sure.
Work your way like that.
Yeah.
You can take your free hand and go like that. And then use that.
Let's go. Number one, here we go. Hold the work.
All right, here we go, guys.
Yeah, I mean, the bridge scene was like an afterthought too when I was scouting and I saw that bridge and I was like, this bridge looks so great. How do I get them out here? What am I gonna do?
It's a fucking dead end.
Fucking dead end. God damn it.
This is it.
Across the bridge and all that, I was like leading up this, you get it. She's holding you.
Yeah, I mean, by this point, you're like,
so doing this even more like, yeah, everything's going to be labor.
Seems like you're going to drop dead trying to get that thing open.
All right, so I think we're good.
It's been a good one. It's, you know, obviously his movies tend to be pretty dark, and he likes to take us to the dark side. This film in particular, I think he's didn't have any restrictions as far as having to adapt to something or, you know, a certain producer or whoever telling him how he had to do it. And so I think he created this film or this world that the only rule is there's no rules, and he can get it is absurd and dark and twisted and surreal, and it all makes sense.
And Rob's whole thing is, the audience is so sophisticated now that if you make things too polished, if you make them too traditional, it gets boring to watch it. And that's something that Rob really pushes, and that's something that I think makes his movies really fun to watch. You know, whether you like it or not, you're gonna see something with a very strong vision, and it's gonna affect you emotionally.
This isn't ballet, you gotta run like a man.
What's that, ballet? Yeah. I've had more fun in other movies, I've had worse times in other movies, other movies may have different things about them, but for some reason, everything I've done up to this point, there's a little bit of all of it in this movie in kind of a different way. And that's what I like about it. You know, there's some of the kooky stuff is in there, there's some of the gritty sort of reject stuff, there's some of the sort of more grand, epic-y looking Lords of Salem stuff, but it's all sort of jammed into one movie.
Yeah, no, I feel really good about it.
You never know how you're gonna feel, you know? You always wanna feel good about it, but, you know, you see how these things get made. Fucking who can tell what the hell's gonna happen at the end of the day. Except for minor problems that I don't remember anymore, everything pretty much worked as good as I could imagine it working under the crazy circumstances that we shot it all.
Thank you.
Who's interviewing who right now? What's going on? So
he's like always has upstage. He's back there getting his makeup on.
Are you trying to feed him? Are you feeding him?
He doesn't need to feed me. He's just getting jam after jam over
just
here.
Just because he's an actor, it doesn't mean he can't think for himself.
Unbelievable. what was the question?
Can you put